Send it to Igila, you that is sending him to me. Tell him I said he's not my spiritual father. And he's not qualified to be my spiritual father. He's a sinner. He's not qualified to be my spiritual father. And Igila is not a pastor. Igila said we praise native doctor. Is native doctor not better than Igila who have two wives?
Okay, Dr. Apostle Kasi, hold it for a minute. The charlatan that Kasi is addressing is one of the biggest witch doctors in Nigeria. After TB Joshua, that is. Igila is not only a native doctor, he's a certified witch doctor. There is proof, there is evidence of Joshua Iginla's witchcraft. He has been caught on record in most of his private meetings with his godfathers of the dark world, consulting, seeking power. So Apostle Kasi is not offside. For now, let's call him an apostle. He deserves to be called an apostle when he's dropping bombs like this. This is the truth that you people need to hear about these native doctors who are rebranding as men of God. Continue listening.
But let me answer some questions. Number one, Igila is not my spiritual father. And Igila can never be my spiritual father. And Igila is not qualified to be my spiritual father. And Igila is not qualified to be a pastor or a prophet. A man of God who cannot take care of his home is not worthy to hold any position in the house of God. If you say I am lying, come and prove it. A man with a second wife in South Africa.
Okay, let me chip in once again. We have one problem in this religious setup called Christianity. We are too forgiving and we forget easily. We pardon nonsense. We allow immorality to spread by our toleration. If there's one religion that is porous, if there's one religion that is weak, it's Christianity. We tolerate almost anything. Igila left his wife. Like, he literally left his wife of many years. A woman that has stood by his side for the longest time ever. And the reason why he left this wife that he built his shrine with is because he had spotted a yellow bone in South Africa. He was coming to do programs in South Africa. He spotted a yellow bone and made that yellow bone carry Bele. She got Bele and he went back to Nigeria and threw the wife away and came to the public lying that the wife was having affairs with other men, which was a blue lie. And his followers came gladly clapping. Yes, Papa, you did the right thing. He wanted to justify his immorality by backing it up with scripture, which says the only reason a man shall leave his wife, or the only reason divorce will be permitted, if one part is caught committing adultery. Igila is one of the, should I put it the right way that I should put it, or I should pardon him and let you listen to Kasi Chuku as he condemns that act of him divorcing his wife. How did you accept that? How did you even accept Chris Oyakhilome divorcing his wife? If you are truly God-fearing and, you know, the scripture-abiding citizens as you claim to be, or the disciples of Christ, then you shouldn't pardon these kind of immoral activities. When someone commits such, must be excused from the pulpit, must go and start another life somewhere else. He can't come back after divorcing a wife and still claim to be a man of God. Apart from that, we know he is a witch doctor. Continue listening to Apostle Kasi Chuku.
The only thing I know about you is your evil and iniquity way. Now listen to me. Wherever you are watching, we are not against fathers. We are against evildoers. Fathers who are full with evil, sinful life. And you want to claim you are a father? Fathers are uniting. Anybody that fight the deed, they are that. They, you start there making noise. Why did you not condemn sin? If it were your pastor that married second wife, by now you could have given the pastor suspension. Nobody suspend you. And you are not even ashamed. You are still talking. Oh, Igila. Oh, Igila. If who I call my spiritual father involved, I know he will not even. If he involved in such an act, I will disfather him. Rubbish. People are clapping for you. Three of you are only hard. Is it not a motto fifim and a motto fifim Jeremiah and Sammy Okpo, Okpo? Let me not make him relevant. Those one who has failed their generation. You people that say you are a father, you are a disappointment to us. Your sinful life is obvious. It's very obvious. Repent. That is what we want from you people. You have crowd, you have private jet, does not gratify you a spiritual. Who made you a spiritual father? A spiritual sons. And now, who told you we are your spiritual son? Do we look like you? Eh? Do we look at me? Do we look like you? Rubbish. Do we look like you? Say my spiritual sons. Spiritual sons. Who see you now go to talk? Say, now true they talk. Spiritual sons. Come out and gratify your reason of marrying a second wife. When you have a wife, I say you notice your wife was sleeping around. Later, your wife confessed to you, and you say you are a prophet. When your wife was sleeping with another man, God did not reveal to you. You see how you people are fooling yourself. See, instead of you people to spread this gospel, this Bible, and the body of Christ, instead of people who make it useless before people who are believing in God and Christ Jesus, we'll make sure you people are useless. What's your problem? Send it to a girl, you that is sending him to me. Tell him I said he's not my spiritual father. And he's not qualified to be my spiritual father. He's a sinner. He's not qualified to be my spiritual father. And a girl is not a pastor. A girl said we praise native doctor. Is native doctor not better than a girl who have two wives?
I think the message is clear here. Iginla is not a man of God. Joshua Iginla has nothing to do with Christ. Okay, if you follow God through Christ and you want someone who can lead you to God, Iginla is not the man. Iginla will only lead you to witchcraft. Iginla will only lead you astray, my people. I'm still surprised we have people that believe that Joshua Iginla is in some way a man of God. I've seen people bowing down, buying his anointing oils and all of his nonsensical so-called anointed materials, hoping that they will have a divine encounter and using these materials as a point of contact. Do you know how many people Iginla has initiated into witchcraft without them knowing? Do you know how many people in his subsidiary branches across Africa are actually in witchcraft without knowing because of their submission to Iginla? My people, learn or perish. It's up to you. I'm just here to just lead you to the truth and make an informed decision before you fall in deep in all these sorcery and witchcraft kind of practices that are being conducted by your so-called DGOs. I rest my case. It's Mr. PDT. And I'm out.
My people, wait till you get to talk about this video. What you just watched now. I bet like, subscribe, and drop your comments under the comment section below. Now, Apostle Cassie, now in they tell us all this one. He say Apostle Iginla or Pastor Iginla. I hope many of you know the story. Pastor Iginla married a Nigerian woman before. So in Congo, South Africa, go preach, go join this woman. When they don't come marry, Pastor Iginla can divorce the first wife. No be smart thing. Who no guessing? Like, raise up your hand. All of us now sinner for the front of God. So nothing like Papa Gio, Mama Gio, or Sister Gio. Now. So now I break off on here. Now this one Apostle Cassie when they talk. Instead now Pastor, Apostle Cassie now Pastor. When this our brother can be analyzer or exposing pastors or whatever I will call him because he don't try well for the industry. A prophet, yes. He don't try for the industry. So like this video, guys, and stay blessed.